超豪華な大豪邸に住んでいる女スーザン、彼女は誰もが羨む財力を持っています。
Mrs. Morrow, a package arrived for you.
元夫エドワードから小包みが届けられます。中身は彼が書いた小説でした。
I wanted you to be the first to read it, so I'm sending along a proof.
Morning. What's that? You guys even talked in 20 years?
19. Last night you didn't come by the gallery.
Really, by the time I left the office, I was late for my dinner.
All right. You and I go to the beach. Maybe if we just spent some time, just the two of us?
Because I gotta go back to the office.
その夜、スーザンは元夫が書いた小説を読んでみます。小説の話に夢中になります。休暇が始まってトニーは家族と遠出します。真っ暗な夜になって田舎道を運転していると、急に現れた車2台が妨害をしてきます。男たちはわざと事故を起こして喧嘩を売ってきますが、タイヤがパンクしてしまって逃げることもできません。トニーは仕方なく車から降ります。妻と娘が車から降りるとまた喧嘩を仕掛けてきます。そして結局心配していたことが起こってしまいます。衝撃的な展開に小説を閉じてしまうスーザン。スーザンの夫は他の女性と浮気をしていました。
Yes. Get some sleep.
その後再び小説に集中し始めます。妻と娘が連れ去られ別々に移動することになったトニー。
Don't speed up.
What the fuck are you doing to us?
You want to see your wife and kid? Then turn down the road. I don't think you need to worry about your wife and kid.
人里離れたところまで車を直接運転していくんですが、トニーはそうやって捨てられてしまいます。その後怪我をした体を引きずって道路の方に向かいますが、岩の隙間に身を隠して様子を見ます。悪夢のようだった夜が過ぎて、トニーは荒れ地を歩き続けてようやく通りにまでたどり着きます。警察に通報した後、モーテルで連絡を待ちます。事件を捜査するために警察が派遣され、
Oh, glad to meet you.
You found my car?
They found it in a creek bed.
It's my understanding these fellas didn't have any guns. You say some fellow named Lou just drove you out into the brush and left you there?
Yes.
Did they say anything?
Mister, your wife wants you.
Okay, I'll take it from here. Sergeant, back up slowly down the shoulder.
Right by the reflector.
Let's get out and walk. You said you walked out, right?
昨夜の記憶をたどって事故現場に向かいます。しかしトニーを待っていたのは信じたくない現実でした。愛する家族が死体で発見され冒険の結果、死亡原因が分かります。
There's something else. We have the cause of death. Your wife had a fractured skull. Your daughter had a much more difficult time. She also had a broken arm. They had both been raped.
警察は容疑者を特定できたのですが、衝撃を受けたトニーは犯人の顔を覚えていませんでした。
He's just a blur.
But what's wrong with you, man?
I sure as hell don't have any other witnesses.
Sure you don't recognize him?
Just a blank.
数日後、犯人と直接向き合うことにしたトニー。
What do you want me to do?
See if you recognize the guy we called. Come on in. You ready to look this fellow in the eye? Let him see you?
No.
That's good. Think it'll help him talk.
That's him? On the far left, that's him.
You ain't that lucky. Get over here.
Your name, Luke?
You know my name, I told you.
Well, I guess I want you to tell me if you ever seen this man before.
No, I don't know. Who is he?
His friends. He forced us off the road on the interstate. Car with my wife and my daughter. And later, my wife and daughter...near the same place.
Well, that ain't right.
I don't know nothing about that. I've never seen him before in my life.
All right. Are you sure this is the man?
Absolutely. Yes.
Good. We got Lou. I bet your friend Ray's the third fella in the holdup. I'm gonna go find Ray.
その後、すべての事件の主犯であるレイを捕まえに向かい。
I'm fine. Follow me. That's Ray Marcus. Does he look like he could be the guy?
Yes.
Let's talk to him.
レイを車に乗せて審問を始めます。
You know your rights, right?
Supposed to bring him to me.
It's illegal, man. I'm supposed to have a lawyer or something.
Want a lawyer? I can take you down to the station and charge you. You recognize this car out there?
Why should I recognize this fucking car?
How about the driver?
You remember him?
I can't see him.
Stop the car, Tony.
Turn around and look at this piece of shit.
Who is this guy?
You don't remember him?
Last summer on the interstate, you killed my wife and my daughter.You and your buddies on the interstate, you forced yourself to work.
You're crazy. That's crazy.
You're fucking crazy.
Tell them what we found there, Tony. Now, we're going to a place you might remember. You can help yourself out by telling me.
I didn't have nothing to do with it.
しかし、レイは犯行を認めずに言い逃れをします。
Yeah, but look inside, Ray.
遺体が発見された現場まで連れてきますが。
Oh, you raped him on the bed, I suppose.
Charges were dropped. I never raped nobody.
I want to know the exact story, what you did to them. I want to know what my wife said.I want to know what my daughter said. I want to know what they felt. I want to know if they hurt this bastard.
確実な証拠がない限り逮捕はできませんでした。
What?
I told you I got lung cancer. It's metastasized. They're not dropping Lou.
Well, it's no fucking good if we don't get right. Do you have anyone in your life?
No.No, why about it?
肺がんで余命が残されてなく家族も残っていないボビー。
What are we gonna do?
It's a question of how serious you are about seeing justice.
ボビーはトニーに正義を行いたいと提案します。
So let me ask you a personal question between you and me. What do you want me to do with Ray Mark? Anything you goddamn like?
Listen, I got nothing to lose. I've seen too many sick fucks like Ray Mark just get on to go outside a strict procedure on this.
Yes.
Yeah, get a little rough, make them suffer. Would you like that?
法的な処罰の代わりに苦痛を与えることにします。
Why don't you take me in if you got new evidence?
Your friend Lou Bates implicated you in the Hastings murder.
Well, looky here.
Lou, what you fucking tell me?
Both of you.
What we should do, Tony, is we should just kill him right now. Maybe Ray will get killed. Resisting arrest.
Oh, you feeling uncomfortable, boy?
Sorry.
What? I'm sorry.
What's that?
What, you gonna cry? Are you gonna cry?
Tony, get over here. Take this.
What'd you say, Tony?
Now, what should we do with these two?
ボビーがトイレに行っている間に逃げてしまって。
Tony, you know I had to shoot him, right?
I don't give a goddamn fuck that you shot him. Fucking glad that he's dead. I should have stopped it.
Should have protected him. I should have seen it coming.
It's okay. You're okay, Lumi. You're a good man. You're a good man.
If he gets to the road, he's gonna hitchhike. We gotta catch him before he gets the ride.
I suspect he's gonna go for the highway. I'll go that direction.
You in trouble for all this?
I'm dying. Remember.
トニーは逃げてしまったレイを探し始めます。トニーの予想通り、古い建物に隠れていたレイ。
Your cop friends?
They're around. Just me for the moment.
You and that fucking gun you don't know how to use. You and that silly gun.
Sit down. Sit down. You sit down or I'll fucking kill you.
彼はトニーをバカにします。
I had it coming to him, your fucking wife and that kid, but you... If your daughter thinks I'm a rapist, then she is, right?
You should fucking kill me.
It's fun to kill people.
It's fun to kill people? Did you have fun killing my wife and daughter? Get up.
Go on. I remember your fucking wife. You're too weak.
翌朝、気絶していたトニーは気がついて。レイは撃たれて死んでいました。血をたくさん流したトニーも結局死んでしまいます。小説を最後まで読んだスーザンはエドワードに会ってみることにしますが、過去スーザンはエドワードに大きく傷つけたことがありました。スーザンの母は貧しい、エドワードが嫌いで二人の結婚に反対しました。
You're too young to get married. And Edward, as sweet as he is, he's too weak for you. He has no money. He's not driven. He's not ambitious.
But he is strong.
Susan, okay, but do not marry him. You'll regret it.
その後、スーザンはエドワードとお別れをすることにします。
The person that you want me to be, but I just can't.
You are.
I'm just really, really unhappy.
I can't do this with you anymore, Edward.
Susan.
その過程で、スーザンは不倫をし、エドワードの子供まで中絶します。
I just don't think I'm ever going to be able to look at Edward again after what I did to his child.
I promise it'll be okay.
Oh my God, no. Edward.
今日紹介したノクターナルアニマルズは2017年に公開されたアメリカのスリラー映画です。ベネチア映画祭で審査員大賞を受賞した作品です。映画の中でまた別の小説の話が展開される、変わっている視点の展開です。スーザンが傷をつけたまま別れた元夫エドワード、そして彼から19年ぶりに届いた小説、自分を捨てたことに対する復讐なのかについては想像の余地を残して映画は終わります。小説の中のトニーの話も面白く、最後に一人残されたスーザンの姿も素晴らしい演出だったと思います。フルバージョンが気になる方はNetflixで視聴いただけます。映画弁当でした。ご視聴ありがとうございました。